This is my Super 73, almost in original condition. We already put on the battery. Today we want to show you how we pimped this bike from original 500 watt motor to a dual motor setup with total 1500 watt.
The first time I saw a Super 73, I wanted one. I was able to demo ride the Super 73 2008 original model with a 1000 watt motor. The bike had a top speed of 26 miles per hour, but the price tag of $3,200 plus $120 for shipping held me back to order it. Lithium Cycles came out with a low cost version, the Super 73 C1. I ordered the bike without knowing any specific specs back then. I didn't care much since I was more interested on how the bike looked. For me it was clear from the beginning that I would put more juice on this bike. My goal was to customize the bike to make it faster than the 2018 original model while spending less money. While I was waiting to receive my bike, I did some research and made myself more familiar with e-bikes and their components. I ended up purchasing a BBSHD mid-drive 1000 watt motor by Lunar Cycle, including a 52 watt battery. I was hoping to be able to upgrade to a Ludacris controller later. The controller is the brain of the e-bike and manage how much power goes from the battery to the motor. Unfortunately, Luna was not selling the Ludacris controller separately from their own bikes. I do like the BBSHD motor because of its compact design. The controller is hidden in the motor housing and doesn't require to be additionally mounted to the bike. A mid-drive motor tend to be lighter and smaller than a hub motor. The day I finally received my bike, I took it for a spin and hey, I need to say, 500 watt hub motor is more powerful than I expected. 21 miles per hour top speed with a range of 50 miles plus is not too bad to keep up with New York's traffic. My first interest was to know how the original setup was working and I took some measurement right away. I removed the seat and checked out how everything is hidden underneath. I was surprised how small the original 36 volt battery was. The motor kit from Luna comes with all the necessary equipment you need. I ordered the 1000 watt hot rod version with 100mm button bracket size, full twist throttle, standard display, 52 Luna mini charger. I didn't really need the spacer kit, but the Luna wrench was very helpful to tie down the motor in place. I was looking to replace the 48 teeth stock sprocket to a lighter 36 teeth aluminium chain ring. The goal was to bring a better torque to the setup, but it didn't work for me as it limits the bike to 25 mph instead of 29. Talking about speed, both motors are installed on the bike and were completed separately from each other. One can be used by the thumb throttle, the other one is activated by the twist throttle. The original motor peaks out at 21 miles per hour, regulated by the controller. That being said, if you are going downhill, the controller will stop providing power and the motor won't run full capacity anymore.
So next thing that you want to do is like changing the grips. They're pretty tight if you're not able to get them off. Get yourself a girlfriend that is strong enough to get them off.
With the BBHSD you can go up to 29 miles per hour with a 48 teeth sprocket. Using both motors combined give you a great acceleration torque, but the issue is that if I'm trying to push the original motor over 21 miles an hour, it shuts down and I have to turn the power switch off and on to get it back to life. Another con of having two motors is that the bike is heavier than original condition. Another issue if you are considering pimping your ride, I found the original brakes a little too weak. They're mechanical brakes, so I swapped them out to hydraulic ones. The brake rotors are IS 160mm. The Shimano M315 MT200 set from Amazon is plug and play and does the job. In the future, I will probably go bigger on the front rotor to practice my stoppies, but for now, the hydraulic brakes are a great option and already an improvement to the stock ones. I have also unplugged the electric brakes. I like to have an option to use the motor in parallel of braking in order to have more control in certain circumstances. I was hoping that the motor with the full twist control would be much smoother, but nope, it's not. I'm probably too spoiled by the boosted board. Also, there is some kind of resistance, like a small clicking when you roll the bike backwards. I reached out to Luna and they came back to me and saying it was normal. It doesn't bother me too much anymore as I'm slow in getting used to it. I know what you're thinking, and yes, it gets kind of expensive, so let me sum up all the parts for you. The bike is 1020 inclusive shipment. The Baofeng motor kit with battery and shipment came up to $1,289. The hydraulic brakes are an additional $69. I also needed a new chain at $7 and a couple more tools, chain breaker at $17, a crank puller for $16, and finally a bottom breaker remover at about $6. Altogether, you're looking at a $2,424 bike. Once everything in place, I got to zip tight all the cables and went for my first ride. I was super disappointed. The torque was great, but the Baofeng peaked out at 21 miles per hour. The controller is programmed to peak out at the speed. But being said, there's a workaround. Hold the plus and minus buttons for a couple of seconds. Change the display to kilometers per hour. Press power to save and move to the next setting. The next setting is the speed limit. Bring it up to max. The next thing is hold plus and minus button again and push 8 times the power button. Now it shows the tire size which you can adjust. The idea is to bring down the tire size by half, what is about 8 to 10 inches. The display will show you the unit of kilometer per hours, but knowing that your current speed is actually in miles per hour. Potentially, the bike could go up to 50 miles per hour now.